Good morning and welcome dear students to all in English video class. Once again we are in English language class and going to start chapter number 25, that is verb, subject, verb and agreement. So student, here we are going to study about the same, what is subject, verb and what about their agreement. Okay, so here on the screen you can see that is written that the subject of a sentence may be singular or plural when the subject is a pronoun. Instead of a noun, it may belongs to the first, second or the third subject. Consequently, the verb in a sentence must agree with the subject in number and person. Okay, so what is wanted to say? If you're talking about subject, so subject is what? Subject can be either noun or pronoun. Okay, subject can be either noun or pronoun. Okay, if the subject can be either noun or pronoun, it must be singular and plural. And in the same way, if it becomes a pronoun, then also it will have a singular subject or a plural subject. Clear, student? So when we are talking about subject, so subject is what? Subject is the doer of the action. Okay, doer of the action, the one who performs action in a sentence. So that can be singular or plural, and also it can be noun and pronoun. Clear? Okay, what about verb? So when we talk verb on a sentence, so verb is a doing words. Okay, what is verb? Verb is doing words or action words. Okay, so what happened once actually, subject and verb, okay, subject and verb had an agreement. What types of agreement? So subject says that if I will be singular, verb must be singular, or I will be plural, must be verb must be plural. So what the rule says that if the subject in our sentence will be singular, this verb also followed the same, and if it will be plural, this verb also followed the same. So that is why this is called an agreement. Okay, they had an agreement that if they will follow a singular subject, verb will automatically follow a singular subject, otherwise it will be a wrong sentence. Okay, see how it can be wrong and how it can be right, we will be discussing in the same class, student. So till here I told that a subject of a sentence may be singular or plural when the subject is a pronoun. Instead of a noun, it may belongs to a first person, second person or the third person. So consequently the verb also followed the same, what agrees to the first, second and third person. Okay, if the subject is a singular, the verb must be singular, or if it is plural, the verb also be plural. So if the subject is a pronoun, the verb must agree with the person of the pronoun, as I told earlier. Okay, now see, there's a example given. She has opened a bookstore round the corner. Okay, so here if we recognize, so you can see that she is a subject, has opened is what? Verb, and then after from here to here is our predicate. Clear? So we are talking about has. What is has? This has is put according to the subject she, because she is a singular subject and also has is a verb that is used for singular subject. Okay, if we will write here have, she have, so that will be completely wrong. Clear, student? Okay, now see that here she is a third person singular pronoun, and the verb has agrees in it number and person. Therefore The verb in a sentence is always dependent on the subject of a sentence. Clear? Now let us see one more example, student. Anand and Rucha are collecting donation for the event. Okay, so Anand is one subject and Rucha is another subject. So here are two subjects that are connected by a plural verb. Okay, so Anand is one subject plus Rucha is one subject, so that becomes plural. So for plural subject we have to use plural verb, that is why here is given are. Otherwise if we will write Anand and Rucha is, so that is रॉन्ग बिकॉज देर आर टू सब्जेक्ट वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट इन द सेंटेंस. दे बोथ आर कलेक्टिंग डोनेशन फॉर द इवेंट. क्लियर स्टूडेंट? ऑल राइट. सो हियर द सब्जेक्ट आनंद एंड रुचा इज प्लूरल मेड अप ऑफ टू नाउन्स एंड द वर्ब आर एग्रीज एग्रीज विद इट इट्स नंबर एंड पर्सन. क्लियर? ओके. नाउ नाउ लेट अस सी सम जनरल रूल. Very general rule that I know that many students maybe you come to know about this. So let us see what it says. The first point says that the third person singular person singular pronoun. Okay, what about the third person? Third person is he, she, it. So all the third person takes singular verb like leaves, yes or yes, so yes or yes concept in the of the v1 form. So there is lives. Okay. L-I-V-E. So if you are going to use life with any singular person, we use S. Clear? So in the same way, it is complete all respect. So life for third person, it also for third person. Second point says the third person plural pronoun they. Okay, they is also third person, but they always have a plural subject. Clear? They also have a plural subject. So that is why it always followed a plural verb. Clear? So they have spoken to him and they are not eligible for the test. So even if it is a third or it is a third person, it always followed a plural verb because it is a plural subject. Clear? All right. Now come down. See the second point says, now here they are talking about second person. If the second person singular as well as plural, what is our second person? That is always you. Okay, takes a plural verb in a tense. Now you can see, you seem sad. What's the matter? Then again, all you, all going to watch the match too. Okay, now children, you can see that here we are talking about you. What is you? You is a second person. Okay, that always followed a plural verb. Clear? Now, what about first person? For the first person, I and we are to be used. And for I, we use am and was. Okay? For we can use all plural verb. Clear, student? See example. I go to the park every day and I have a dog named Jess. So if the singular pronoun I takes a plural verb in all cases were except be that I told that I ke saath we always use am. Okay, so there is a be form of the verb for I. Otherwise it always takes a plural verb. Okay, and what about we? So for we use the same. All plural, always plural. See that we are, not we is. We practice, not we practices. Clear? So I hope that these things are clear to you. Okay, student. Now I'm going to tell you about rule 1. Okay, what our rule 1? Rule 1 is, and I'm going to talk about rule 1 that is completely based on and. I will be provided a PDF form to you, but first of all try to understand what I want to say you. So children, here I'm going to write some sentence. According to that sentence, you have to identify which types of verb we have to follow here. Okay, so simple sentence I will write here. First of all, I will write Ram and Riya, okay, dash going to a party. My writing is not very good here, but I hope that my students are understanding what I just want to write and want to say you, want to explain you. So student, here you can see that Ram and Riya dash going to a party. So according to this sentence, what types of verb we have to put? So if you want to say, you I know that you cannot say, but you can comment on the comment section. What is your answer? You can comment there, and according to that, you can communicate to. So student, I just wrote a sentence that is I was talking about rule one. And okay, using and. So I just wrote a sentence that is. Ram and Ria dash going to a party. Okay, so I told that what types of verb we use in a sentence. So I hope that students will write their answer in comment box. So here we can see that Ram and Ria. Ram is one subject and Ria is another subject. So if there are two subject using and. Two subject that is adding or that is joined by, and we use what plural verb. So Ram and Ria, what will be answer? Are going to a party. Clear student? Yes. Okay. Now again I will write one another sentence. That will be sentence number two. Just wait. Sentence number two. I will write here. Bread and butter, okay. Bread and butter dash available in my shop, okay. So second sentence says that dash and bread and butter dash available in my sentence. So student, here I will give you option is as are. So is and are, what is the answer? You can write in the comment box so that I can understand that my students are also listening me. They are try to understanding me. So you will say that ma'am, bread and butter are two subjects. So we will use here are, okay. And some will say that no ma'am, bread and butter, there are two subjects, but answer of course will be are, okay, because bread is one subject and here butter is another subject. So bread also available in my shop as well butter. Clear? Okay, but I will give you one more sentence the same. Suppose a student, I'm just erasing this one, just wait. Okay, I will write again. Bread and butter dash my favorite breakfast. Okay, suppose that I have written that bread and butter dash my favorite breakfast. Again, the same option I will give is an. So here the same student will say that ma'am, bread and butter is my favorite breakfast. It means there are two subject, bread and butter. So there will be are. But no, my dear student, here will be is. Okay, because here we are talking about one idea. What is my favorite breakfast? Bread and butter. Okay, when we are going to use bread, it must be used with butter. So that is my favorite breakfast. So that is why it is used here singular verb. Okay, bread and butter is my favorite breakfast, because when we use two bread, then after we put inside the butter, inside the bread, what? The butter. So that is why bread and butter is talking about a single idea. So here will be a singular subject as well a singular verb. Clear? Okay, I hope this rule is clear to you. Okay, one more thing I will write. What you tell, what will be the next answer here? Rice and curry. Rice and curry dash his favorite food item. Okay, rice and curry dash his favorite food item. Answer is an R. So here student, you can see that this is also joined by conjunction and rice and curry, they are talking about the same idea, single idea. So that is why here we use इज राइस एंड करी इज हिज फेवरेट फूड आइटम. क्लियर? ओके स्टूडेंट, सो दैट इज वाई आई विल टेल यू वन मोर एग्जाम्पल. ओके, वी विल हैव ग्रीन नाउ दिस टाइम. सो आई विल राइट वन मोर एग्जाम्पल टू यू. जस्ट वेट. स्टूडेंट जस्ट वेट प्लीज. ओके, सो सपोज आई एम राइटिंग फायर एंड वाटर. ओके, डैश फायर एंड वाटर डैश एग्री. ओके, और व्हाट इज द ऑप्शन? ऑप्शन विल बी डू नॉट एंड डज नॉट. ओके, सो डू इज यूज फॉर सिंगुलर, डू इज यूज फॉर प्लूरल एंड डज इज यूज फॉर सिंगुलर. ओके, दैट इज प्लूरल. सो फायर एंड वाटर डू नॉट एग्री और डज नॉट एग्री. दैट इज, सो माई स्टूडेंट विल राइट योर आंसर इन कॉमेंट बॉक्स. बट मोस्ट आई थिंक दैट मोस्ट ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स आर थिंकिंग दैट मैम फायर एंड वाटर दैट इज ऑल्सो ज्वाइनिंग बाई एंड एंड दे आर ऑल्सो गिविंग द सेम सेंस. बट नो माई स्टूडेंट, यू कैन सी दैट फायर एंड वाटर दे नेवर कैन बी टुगेदर. ओके, दे नेवर दे बोथ आर रियली कंट्रास्ट टू ईच अदर, ऑपोजिट टू ईच अदर. ओके, सो दैट इज वाई वी यूज डू नॉट. डू नॉट. ओके, फायर एंड वॉटर डू नॉट एग्री. सो दैट इज वाई यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट वेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट सिंगल आइडियाज एंड वेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट टू सब्जेक्ट्स. ओके, सो देर आर टू डिफरेंट सब्जेक्ट, वन इज फायर एंड वन इज वॉटर. सो आई होप स्टूडेंट दिस थिंग्स आर क्लियर टू यू. देन आफ्टर देर आर सम मोर पॉइंट दैट आई विल बी एक्सप्लेनिंग टू यू इन वन ऑफ माई नेक्स्ट वीडियो. सो स्टूडेंट टिल दैट टाइम I just want to say you that if you have any doubt, please do comment in the comment section. So that is why that will be what we can say that I encourage with your comment, and then after I will make different video for you. If you have any query and please ask there. So till that time, thank you so much and have a nice day.